Rosmer number 12 there, the scorer for Liverpool. And Trevor Cherry getting the equaliser for Leeds United. So it's now up to Ray Clements and David Harvey. And the competition going to take place in the goal to our right at the end of the players' tunnel. The linesman already in position to check that the goalkeeper doesn't move. Bob Mathewson coming up. And alongside him, Peter Lima. So, Peter Lima against Ray Clements. One nothing to Leeds United. Alec Lindsay now against David Harvey. One apiece. Johnny Giles and a lot of whistles for him. Two-one to Leeds. Emlyn Hughes now to try his luck against David Harvey. Well, we're seeing a number of different types of penalties. That was the blaster. Before that, we saw Johnny Giles place it. Two apiece. Eddie Gray, the next to go. Three, two. But he can't be taken. A kick of very different style to that of Emlyn Hughes. Brian Hall, the job of making it 3-3. Which he does very comfortably. The penalty kicking so far of a very high standard. Brian Clough smiling, the two goalkeepers exchanging pleasantries. And Mr. Back to Legs himself, Norman Hunter. Four, three. Norman Hunter, who played here in 1965 in the cup final, being followed by another player who did so on the opposite side, of course, Tommy Smith. Four apiece. So Trevor Cherry coming up for the last of Leeds five penalties. If there's no verdict, then we go into sudden death. Once the side is established in front, that's it. But if Cherry was to miss this, Liverpool would still have to take number five. Spot making the ball look a little bit flat, but it's not, although it's been hammered a fair bit this penalty competition. Clements not too far away from that. 5-4. The goalkeepers might be wondering whether they'll end up taking penalties against each other. Peter Cormack with Liverpool's number 5. In all possible senses, wearing number 5 shirt, taking their 5th penalty to take us into sudden death. At this rate, we could be here all night. The goalkeeper's looking to see who comes next. special union, of course. Oh, it looks as though Harvey is going to take against Clements. Well, there was a Charity Shield match in which Pat Jennings scored against Alex Stepney, but that was in the normal 90 minutes and from a goal kick, from a clearance. But Clements still has to take his. That's not it. What a lovely picture. And in fact, Callaghan is coming up to take. So Clements not being given the responsibility. So Ian Callaghan, the footballer of the year, with the chance to give Liverpool the Charity Shield. Which he does. Bill Shankly congratulating Bob Paisley first. The players congratulating Callaghan. So the cup winners beat the league champions. And the last time that happened was in 1962 when Spurs beat Ipswich. And those two have met many times before, Emlyn Hughes and Bill Shankly. And except for the most staunch Leeds United supporters, I think there will be a certain feeling that it's nice for Bill Shankly to have won the last time he was here. So Emlyn Hughes comes up to collect the Charity Shield from the former president of FIFA, Sir Stanley Rouse. Hat on again. There were plenty of those going around at Wembley last May. Well, a happy end. Sir Stanley Rouse there. Ted Croker. Mr. Smith, the chairman of Liverpool Football Club. T.B. Williams, the president. Mr. Cross, also on the board. Bill Boisma, consolation for him for missing the final. Alec Lindsay, Peter Cormack, Ray Clements. So Liverpool prepared to go on yet another lap of honour. And Bill Shankly will go with them, if his supporters will let him do so. Peter Cormack, who really had a very fine game indeed. Everybody wants to get round Bill Shankly. So Bill Shankly breaks into a jog trot to take away the last trophy that Liverpool can win under his managership. Takes the Charity Shield into the dressing room. One in a penalty competition after the score at the end of 90 minutes was 1-1.